wash whiter than white. Your colors will come alive, and your family will thank you for it. It's more than a detergent. It's a way of life.
She sure is pretty, isn't she?
Yeah, she's a real piece.
It's not what I meant. I meant she looks real nice.
Yeah, she's a real nice piece.
I'm gonna have to tell her. She's gonna come walking in that door. I'm gonna have to shatter her.
Did you have a tough day, honey?
I feel sorry for her. Locked up in that place all the time.
You're right, pal. Somebody ought to do something about that. And I know just the guy.
Hold it. Here comes the doctor.
Oh, no. Not big bad Dr. Arno making a house call. And you're gonna cover for me.
What?
Just make sure the camera in the corridor is shut off, and it stays that way till I get back.
What's the matter, honey?
Every night, I can't sleep.
Did you have a rough day?
No, I have nothing.
They found Klaus, and if that bastard talks, we're ruined.
That's all right, honey. You still love me and the kids.
Stop it, Moya. Neither you nor I have any kids, and you know it.
I have to. No one else will.
Don't worry, sweetheart.
It's just no use. I can't take this anymore. No, everything's not...
Everything's gonna be fine.
I told you never to do that. You watch too much TV.
No, I'm sorry.
I was just practicing. I thought...
That's just the problem. You don't think sometimes.
You're right. I'm sorry.
Maya, please, not now. I've got to figure out what I can do about Klaus.
I can help you with that. If you let me.
You know as well as I do.
Thank you. fight evil, no matter where, no matter when, and no matter what the cost.
Hold still.
Yeah, it looks like you broke it.
It's a tough break, pal. Looks like game over, Stone.
5 more points to game. Can you do it?
Enough. Looks like it's game over to me, too.
Pete. Come here. I want to talk to you. Come here. Playing for pink slips.
Yeah.
Well, my bike's on the line.
Yeah?
5 points to game.
Yeah.
Well, can you help?
Is he serious?
Yeah, good.
Take your jacket and shirt off, leave your tie on, and we'll beat him. All right, let's take them.
Well, there's no other alternative.
Let's go, that's it, here we are. Come on, put the points down, let's go.
New suit. We win this, I'll buy you 2. You ready?
Ready.
Feelings, I hope, Sport?
Yeah, no problem, Sport. Just one nose gonna teach you how to drive it.
Same guy that taught me to play volleyball. Huh? You come with a bike.
Not.
Ah, you guys got no sense of humor.
The brutality of those killings, absolutely shocking.
Why would anyone go to such extremes to get their hands on her?
She was an associate of Dr. Arno's.
Yeah, and I see that he's an East German. Won a Nobel Prize 25 years ago.
Now, his research laid the foundation for many subsequent discoveries in the field.
But someone chose to take her. Why?
Well, perhaps he resisted. She was the next best thing.
Yeah, but for whom?
For any number of Western companies when East Germany collapsed. They were all after Arno. Ironically, he chose Crestline, which happens to be a recent acquisition of ours.
It's all beginning to sound vaguely reminiscent of the end of the Second World War. Though, of course, then the premium was on rocket scientists.
Our stock and trade was machines in those days. Now we're dealing with humans.
Yeah. So what specifically was Arno doing at Crestline?
Basic genetic research. Arno was very secretive about his work, paranoid that his discoveries would be snapped up at any moment. He came over to Crestline because we guaranteed him total privacy. That's Noel Astridge. The head of Crestline, shaking hands with Arno the day he arrived.
And that's Moya.
Yeah, that's Moya. You spent most of her life working with Arno, so you can bet that what she knows is worth a fortune.
Then it would seem to me that whoever's taken her would want to keep her alive.
At least until they get what they want.
Arno's murder was absolutely brutal.
Judging by the job they did on these guards, these guys were gorillas.
Do we have any suspects?
No, well, I mean, nothing specific. Alexander is leaning towards Crestline's competitors as being the prime suspects.
Why kill your target?
Well, I asked him the same question. Oh, I don't know. Maybe Arno just put up too much of a struggle.
Pete, these guards weren't exactly 98-pound weaklings. Whoever wanted to get Arno would have got him.
Which leaves Moya. She was Arno's assistant.
Yes, and unfortunately, we don't have much background on her.
Except she and her boss were East Germans.
Yeah, which means?
Stasi. Has some of the toughest guys I ever ran up against.
No. Had. Remember, those guys are out of business.
What do you think they did with those gorillas? Put them in the zoo?
That's a fair point. Well, after there are going to be no shortcuts on this one, we're just going to have to get as much background as we can on Arno, Moya, the whole shooting match.
Yeah, 10-4. Inspector Campbell's on the scene here. Fingerprint boys are doing the best they can right now.
So, Mr. Astridge, still no ransom demands?
Nothing.
There seem to be very few patients here.
There are no patients at this facility, Mr. Mott. This is a research unit. Moya was being studied, untreated.
Thank you.
And this place was out of bounds to everyone except Dr. Arno.
Was he the only one with a key?
There was one at the security desk for emergencies.
I thought Moya was Dr. Arno's associate.
Actually, she was a subject of his research.
Is that why she was kept locked up?
And Moya was a very valuable resource, the basis of all Arno's work.
So you just let him play God?
Mr. Mott, Arno's work could potentially yield genes that could cure everything from AIDS to cancer.
And make billions of dollars.
Yeah, and with that kind of money resting on her, your competitors must have been very interested in Moya.
In more ways than one. You see, biotechnology is the world's fastest growing and most volatile industry. When we announced that Arno was coming to Crestline, our stocks jumped 75%. Now, when word gets out that he's dead, I expect as great a drop in price. Now, if we announce that Moya's missing too, I shudder to think.
Well, let's hope that won't be necessary.
Mm-hmm.
You got this room on tape?
Yeah, all these facilities are routinely videotaped.
You got the tapes?
You'll have to speak to the police about that. They took them.
I had to talk to them anyway.
Who's this?
That's Ari, Moya's sister. Her twin sister, actually.
That's news. Where is she?
She lives in a cottage on the Crestline grounds.
What about protection?
Ari's in no danger. Arno's experiments were concentrated on Moya and her genetic makeup.
I'd like to see her.
Well, that can be arranged.
When?
Right now, if you like.
Yes.
Come around. I'm going to go and see the police, but in the meantime, don't let your sense of morality blind you to the job at hand.
And don't let the job blind you to the truth of what went on here.
I should warn you. Ari's rather shy and occasionally a little unstable.
Is that why you've kept her hidden too?
Neither one of these girls had what could be called a normal childhood.
I suppose there was a very good reason for that. Wasn't there?
Both sisters are susceptible to fits of depression. Now, Moya's were easily controllable because she was constantly under observation.
And Ari?
When she first arrived here, she was heavily sedated. She tried to kill herself.
So you just took her out here and hoped for the best?
Hardly. She underwent counseling and seems considerably better. In fact, she's been off her medication for some time now.
How much does she know about her sister?
We've thought it best not to tell her anything about what happened to Moya. I'd like to speak with you. Ari, open the door. Ari, open the door. I have some friends here who would like to speak with you. Ari!
It's all right. We'll come back later.
Who are you?
I'm Gabrielle Germont, and this is my colleague, Mr. Stone.
What do you want?
To talk with you. We hope you might be able to help us.
Just you.
Closely as this World Trade Center commemorative proof transforms into a breathtaking standing sculpture of the Twin Towers. It is entirely clad in 24-karat gold and in 0.999 pure silver, actually recovered from vaults beneath the ashes of Ground Zero. The gleaming Twin Towers actually rise up like hope from the shadow of Ground Zero over the shining city. To mark the fifth anniversary of September 11th, National Collectors Mint has authorized a private, non-monetary minting that will never be released for circulation. But it is available now through this special offer for collectors only. New York City shines in frosted relief against a mirror surface with our promise we will never forget. Then, in a second distinct striking, the stunning skyline of the Twin Towers is inset with jeweler precision, able to rise up into a breathtaking standing sculpture. On the reverse, the proud eagle proclaims, "God bless America," wings spread under the five stars that mark each year since 9/11. To honor all who were lost that fateful day, $5 of every proof order is donated to official 9/11 family charities and memorials. This could be the most meaningful collectible you will ever own. Our fifth anniversary tribute proof is clad in 15 milligrams each of 24-karat gold and 0.999 pure silver. Priceless silver recovered from the heart of Ground Zero. The final edition price was to be set at $49, but during this special release, it can be yours for just $29.95. Each comes with a certificate of authenticity confirming its Ground Zero recovery content. When the shrinking supply of silver from Ground Zero is finished, this striking will end forever. So there is a strict limit of 5 per order. Don't miss out on this historic offer. Call now.
Call 1-800-326-1398. That's 1-800-326-1398. Strict limit of 5 commemoratives per caller at 1-800-326-1398.
Hey, Greta, what's cooking?
Dempster's Whole Grains.
Good. A healthy diet low in saturated and trans fats may reduce the risk of heart disease. Dempster's Whole Grains are low in saturated and trans fats.
I'm reading that right out the bag.
Yeah, but it's the whole grain truth. And look, it has the Health Check logo, so you know it's a smart choice.
With Dempster's Whole Grains, great taste and nutrition are in the bag.
Any way you slice it.
Visit Dempsters.ca to learn how to get a free Eat, Shrink, and Be Merry cookbook. Plus, enter to win a VIP weekend, including an evening with Janet and Greta.
I am Ari. I was just making some tea.
I'd love some. Thanks. This is a lovely place.
You're here about my sister.
What makes you think that?
Everyone always asks about Maya.
I'd like to help both of you.
You can't help Maya. She's not here.
How do you know that?
I can feel it. Please. You look so surprised, Miss German. Have you not heard of telepathy between twins? You see, Maya and I are connected even more closely than normal twins. In fact, we are probably closer to being one person than any two people on this planet.
I'd like to know more about your relationship.
I can feel her. Right here. Most of the time, I know what she's thinking. And sometimes... I talk too much. Maya always says that.
Ari, please. Tell me what you were going to say.
She's gone, isn't she?
Yes. But if you can help us find her, you might save her life.
Who sent you?
I'm not working for Astridge. Or anyone at Crestline.
For Dr. Arno?
No.
You must understand. Dr. Arno did things to us. Mostly to Maya. I don't want him near us again.
The men I work for would unknowingly allow others to hurt you or your sister.
They already have. These Americans, they're no different than the Russians. They think we're objects, experiments.
Help us find your sister. I guarantee neither of you will have to go through any more experimentation. Here or anywhere else.
I must protect Maya.
That's exactly what we will do.
Inspector Campbell?
Sinclair, heard a lot about you. So you work with Scotland Yard?
Yeah, a while ago.
Some mess, huh?
Yes.
You know, the last murder weapon we had recorded in Crestline was a flintlock pistol?
And what's your prognosis on this latest one?
Arno died of multiple contusions to the neck. His head was nearly broken clean off.
Same goes for the guards?
The autopsy report is probably going to read, bludgeoned with a blunt instrument. But to tell you the truth, I've never seen anything like it. Busted heads, broken backs, half the bones in their bodies were smashed. I'd say they were pulverized.
And how many perpetrators?
Had to be more than a couple. They started at the security desk, did the guards, then went to the girls' room, killed Arno, and took her.
And the guards never called for help?
No. That's what makes me think we're talking about at least three or four perps. They had to overcome the guards quickly without firing a shot.
And still no word on Miguel?
No. Now I've got a question for you.
Yeah?
Are you working for Astridge?
No, I work for his boss, Alexander Addington.
You know, Crestline pulls considerable weight around here.
Yes, I know. And I imagine that Mr. Astridge steps on a few toes.
Well, I've got small feet. But he has been extremely uncooperative.
Well, he does have a lot to protect.
And I've got a triple murder to solve and a meteor already on my back.
Sounds like you could use a little help.
Well, I would appreciate it, yes.
Where would you like to start?
Why don't we start with a cigar and a coffee?
I'll take a rain check on the cigar, but I could kill a cup of coffee. Lead the way.
Anyone else would take months to get these files out of Moscow. Doesn't hurt to have Mr. Yeltsin owe you a favor.
Well, apparently no one's had any time to translate them. How's your Russian, Bennett?
My wolfhound? Splendid, sir. We have a secret weapon. Miss Previn, we're ready for you now.
Don't tell me Miss Previn can translate Russian.
I don't have to. This will make everybody fluent. It's a computerized scanner. It translates Russian into English.
You don't say. I mean, 20 years ago, I could have made a fortune with this little gizmo.
You made a fortune without it.
Yes, but think how much quicker it could have been.
Yeah, I suppose so.
Satellite link.
Good evening, sir.
Glad you called. Dr. Arno's files just arrived from Moscow.
Oh, good. We could use those as soon as possible.
As soon as they're translated. You've begun analyzing the surveillance tapes?
Yes, sir, we certainly have. And we think we may have found something, Stone.
I'll patch it into you, Mr. A. See what you think.
Now, one of those tapes was from Moya's room. Seems that Arno blanked that one out himself.
Apparently, it was a habit of his. He used to visit Moya every night.
Must have had a real thing about peeping Toms.
Well, this time it worked against him and us.
The other tape was from the corridor camera. Now, that tape blanked more than 3 minutes before the entire system went down.
So the guards never saw what came down that corridor toward them.
Yeah, exactly. Now, the police are working on the assumption that the security desk was hit first, but we think it was the other way around. That Arno was killed, and then the security guards.
You mean whoever took Moya was already inside the building?
That's what we thought. But when we went over the tapes, we couldn't find anything.
Oh, come on. There must have been someone in there. That girl just didn't vanish into thin air.
Senator George Deacon announced today that investigators for his committee have located Klaus Reichman, reputed to be the former head of East Germany's top secret scientific research branch. Deacon revealed that Reichman, who was hiding in New York, will be flown to Washington tomorrow to testify before his committee. The senator expects Reichman to shed some light on the nature of the experiments performed by the communist regime, as well as disclose the names and whereabouts of other East German officials who fled to the West after the wall came down.
Meanwhile,
Washington. Hi. I'm Skip. What's your name?
Moya.
Oh, where did you get a name like that?
What's the matter? You like it?
I love it. You just don't hear it every day. So, Moya. You like TV?
I love TV.
Me too. That's a hell of a dress you got on there.
Do you really think so? I think it might be just a little bit too tight. What do you think?
No, it's perfect.
Skip, do you have a car?
Well, what do you think?
Oh, it's very nice. Sleek. I bet it's fast, too.
Like you, huh?
You want to find out?
Hey, Moya.
What the hell?
Clues tell the biggest stories.
The dead speak to me, Colonel, but give the poor man time to catch his breath.
I have an eyewitness.
It's a smokescreen.
The most engaging shows.
The next number series could be our next victim.
And the most compelling stars.
It could be a hoax.
You want to take that chance?
Are evidence of great TV. Mystery TV. Brought to you by your neighborhood Kelsey's. Cheers to good food.
It can happen at any time. The scorching pain of acid reflux. And when it does, I take a moment. And I take Gaviscon. You can actually feel its foaming action as soon as you take it. And since you can count on Gaviscon for fast heartburn relief, it's almost as if it never happened. Gaviscon, and it's gone.
We all know how our floors get dirty, but how do we get them clean? We use a dirty mop with dirty water. No wonder our floors never get clean. There's got to be a better way. Well, now there is. Introducing the all-new H2O Mop, the world's ultimate cleaning solution that harnesses the dirt-devouring and super-sanitizing power of steam to finally get your floors clean, really clean. The H2O Mop is super lightweight and super maneuverable.
It lifts up every speck of dirt. It's just amazing.
The H2O Mop with manufacturer's one-year warranty has a suggested retail price of $179. A great value. But call now and we'll slash the price. And you can have your own revolutionary H2O with two super absorbent microfiber pads, the H2O glider for carpets and rugs, and 10 free disposable pads, all for only four easy payments of just $33. But order today, and we'll make the last payment for you. Now, that's a $230 value for the incredible price of only three easy payments of just $33. Hold on, we're gonna make this offer irresistible. Order in the next 20 minutes, and we'll send you the amazing H2O portable steam cleaner, a $60 value free. It blasts away dirt, grime, and grease without scrubbing. Now your entire house can be sparkling clean with the power of steam. Altogether, that's over a $290 value for only three easy payments of just $33. Call now.
To order this special television offer, have your credit card ready and order the amazing H2O mop and receive the H2O portable steamer free. Just pay additional shipping. Make one single payment or use our convenient payment plan of just three easy payments of only $33. Log on to Thane.ca, call or send check or money order for the full amount to the address on your screen. Ask operator for details. Order now.
Sir, all the checks on Dr. Arno's most recent background keep coming up blank.
Same for Klaus Reichmann.
And the Kremlin continues to deny having any current information on either of them.
There's something wrong here. President Yeltsin has virtually opened all the KGB files to the West. Why are these being suppressed?
I even accessed the Russian Academy of Science files on parapsychology and twin research. Arno's never mentioned after 1970.
Yeah, and genetics was exactly the same. I mean, the man wins a Nobel Prize and then vanishes. As far as Moscow is concerned, he never existed.
Sir, we have an update from Washington, courtesy of the Deakin Committee. Apparently, Arno worked in a secret East German political retraining facility before he moved to the West. They're sending us all the details they have on him ASAP.
Well, Astrid should have known that. After all, he was the one that hired Arno.
You know the facility Arno was working in? It was, in fact, a Stasi operation, and it was run by Klaus Reichmann.
Seems that Reichmann will testify before Deakin's committee, already investigating certain human rights violations in East Germany.
Well, then it's possible that Reichmann was just trying to cover his trail before talking to Deakin's committee.
According to this, he has the perfect alibi. He's been under protective custody for more than 2 weeks.
Sir, can we go back to Astridge and get some straight bloody answers?
Absolutely. I hate the direction in which this is going. I mean, Crestline is too important an institution to be destroyed by some damn cover-up.
Link out.
Let's go make the canary sing.
I knew it was you. Of course you knew it was me. Just as I knew you'd be waiting for me. I am so glad you're safe.
No, Ari. On the contrary. Neither one of us is safe yet. We have to leave here right now.
What about Dr. Arno?
Forget about Dr. Arno. He can't help us now. Uncle Klaus is in this country.
You've seen Uncle Klaus?
No, but he's here. And we have to find him by tomorrow, or everyone's going to find out about us. Come on.
No, Moya. You can't.
But I must, Ari. You know what they will do to us if he tells them. Unless I bury our past completely, we will never be safe. Now let's go.
I thought this was all over. Moya, I won't let you do this. You won't let me? Ari, I need your help. Maya, you can't bury the past. If you continue, they'll hunt you down and they'll kill you. Not if I'm successful. Not if you help me. You've already started again, haven't you? I could feel you do it. I didn't have a choice. I needed his car so I could come here and get you. Besides, I couldn't help myself. He kissed me. Oh, Maya, you were doing so well. Stop it, Ari. We have to kill Klaus. He's going to Washington. Then what? Then we're finally free. Both of us. Come on. Maya, please. We don't have to do this. There are some people who could help us. People? Have you been talking to someone? Astrid sent her. But she doesn't work with him. She knows about Dr. Arno, but... But I know she's good. Really? Tell me about her.
I've told you everything.
Wrong. Arnie worked for the KGB and Stasi. You forgot, remember?
Like for the past 25 years.
Well, all their best scientists did.
Astrid. Alexander Addington wants you to tell us everything you know. Everything. Otherwise, he'll have no choice but to send you out for accessory to murder.
Look, we never wanted those girls. But Arno wouldn't sign on without them.
Why? What was he working on?
I have his private files. Excuse me. I took them from his lab after he was killed.
Why don't you give us the short version?
Basically, Moya's genetic material was engineered by Arno to fit certain specifications.
What specifications?
She's fluent in 5 languages. She can integrate herself into any society without even getting a second glance from anyone. She's virtually a chameleon.
Is that why you felt it was necessary to keep her locked up?
We were doing whatever we could to render her harmless.
Like what? Massive drug therapy? Electroshock? Isolation? What did you use on her?
Frankly, we were desperate enough to try just about anything.
Why?
Before they were born, Arno extracted genetic material from Ari, modified it, and put it into Moya.
What did Arno create?
Arno augmented Moya's arousal with heightened aggression. Human contact triggers her. She's the perfect killing machine. I suspect that somehow, inadvertently, Arno triggered Moya that night.
Why the hell didn't you tell us that before?
How can I admit that we were harboring a genetic Frankenstein?
Is she programmed for a hit now?
I don't know. Honestly.
Did you know that Reichman was going to testify before the Deacon Committee?
Astrich, did you pass that piece of information on to Arno?
Yes. Yes, I told him. I was afraid that we were all going to be discredited by Reichman. That he would expose Arno and Moya and ruin us all.
So the perfect killing machine is locked in on Reichman.
Well, if that's the case and she succeeds, Crestline and Addington are going to be complicit. How the hell are we going to find her?
How are we going to find her?
What? You think she knows what Moya's mission is?
She shares something special with her sister. You could call it telepathy. If anyone can help us find Moya, it's Ari.
You're going to have to release Ari to us.
I'll make the necessary arrangements.
Peter. She doesn't trust him. I think it's better if I talk to her.
Okay.
Ari? Hi, Ari. Are you all right? Say something.
Maya was here.
What? What did she want?
She wanted me to help her.
On her mission? Did she tell you where she was going?
She's going to kill Klaus. We have to stop her. I'm afraid of what might happen to both of them.
Come with me.
Cinema.
Hey, Greta, what's cooking?
Dempster's whole grains.
Good. A healthy diet low in saturated and trans fats may reduce the risk of heart disease. Dempster's whole grains are low in saturated and trans fats.
Are you reading that right out the bag?
Yeah, but it's the whole grain truth. And look, it has the Health Check logo, so you know it's a smart choice.
With Dempster's whole grains, great taste and nutrition are in the bag.
Any way you slice it.
Visit Dempster's.ca to learn how to get a free Eat, Shrink, and Be Merry cookbook. Plus, enter to win a VIP weekend, including an evening with Janet and Greta.
Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, help me stand. I'm tired, I'm weak, I am storm through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, and lead me on.
You can take a child's hand right now. Please call and reach out to a child in desperate need. You can bring hope to a girl like Raina, who sifts through garbage all day just to survive.
Precious Lord, take my hand.
You can help an orphan like Azazah, whose mother and father died of AIDS.
I'm tired. I'm weak.
You can save the life of a child like Safi, who is 9 years old and weighs only 31 pounds.
The storm through the night.
All it takes is about a dollar a day. Call now for the photo and story of a child you can help.
Precious Lord, lead.
Don't put it off, because every moment matters to the child who's waiting for you. Please call World Vision and sponsor a child today.
And lead.
Change a life. Change your own.
We've located Senator Deacon, sir, and convinced him to come into our L.A. office. He's on the video link now, sir.
That's good work, Bennett.
I think I should warn you, sir, that the senator is not a particularly happy camper.
Satellite link.
Eric, we've been combing Washington for you.
It's election year, Alex. You've been interrupting my stumping for contributions.
Oh, sorry about that, but this is important.
And my re-election isn't?
Reichman, remember? He'll be the first witness before your committee. Well, someone out there is stalking him.
He's in protective custody.
No, this isn't just an idle threat, Eric. This particular assassin is one of his own creations.
I'm sorry. What?
It's a woman. He's developed her as the perfect killing machine.
Well, do you know where she is?
Well, that's why I'm calling you. She's locked onto Reichman, wherever he is.
Well, he's headed for Washington. But we're keeping his movements under wraps.
That won't make any difference. She'll find him.
I'll have your people contact my office. I'll tell them to expect your call. We can't risk losing Reichman.
Thanks.
Link out.
Peter, I've contacted Senator Deacon, and he's arranged for you to meet with the U.S. Marshal and accompany Reichman to Washington on the shuttle.
Yes, sir, we're already here. You know, it's hardly the ideal place for a confrontation with a killer of this training and experience.
I agree, but the story I told him was not exactly persuasive. If we didn't know each other, I'm sure Deacon would have written this threat off of sheer madness.
Which is exactly what it is, but you know, Moya will reach her target at any cost. She's proved that already.
She may not choose to strike in New York.
She may wait until they reach Washington, or even, heaven forbid, she might attack the plane somehow.
Yes, sir, we have already thought of that. We'll be in touch. Bye.
Our only lead for finding the world's greatest killing machine is through her sister's telepathy.
Right. Yeah, don't remind me.
Come on, Harry.
What's she doing here?
Relax, we're just following orders, Reichman.
This wasn't part of the deal.
Look, Senator Deacon said we should bring her to Washington, so we are bringing her to Washington.
I would never have agreed to this if I knew she was coming.
Yeah, well, you sit down and keep quiet or I'll slap the cuffs on you.
What's your position, Peter?
We've just finished sweeping the West Wing and there's nothing. I'm moving down towards the shuttle gate. I'm going to join up with Stone in the terminal building.
All right, out.
Stone, found anything?
It's like looking for a needle in a haystack.
Yeah, well, any better ideas would be gratefully received. But be patient. Between the three of us, we've got the place covered.
How much time before the flight?
19 minutes.
All right, catch you later.
Since Mr. Sinclair is headed for Stone's position, I think we should start down to the gate. There's only a few minutes left till departure.
All right. Harry, it's time to go.
Moya's here, isn't she, Ari? Where's Moya, Ari?
Come on, Reichman. I got plenty of people looking out for us.
Where is she? You must make her tell us where her sister is.
All I have to do is get both of you to Washington, okay? Now, move it. She is not going to talk to you. Now, let's go.
We're on our way to the gate, Peter.
Roger.
She's out there, isn't she?
Maya's very anxious to see you again, Uncle Klaus.
Thank you.
ready.
Don't wait, son.
Moya, Moya, please. Moya, you can't bury your past. If you continue, they'll hunt you down and they'll kill you.
Hold it or I'll shoot.
No, please. No, I won't let you do this. Please, they will kill you. Stop it, Moya. You're the one who's come here to kill Uncle Klaus before he goes to Washington.
Shoot! Shoot before she gets any closer.
Moya, please. These people want to help you. Stop it, Moya. I've come here to help you.
Shoot!
No!
Bring her this way. Harry.
Have made the Deacon Committee's work a hell of a lot simpler, I can tell you. And Klaus Reichmann was entirely candid about what he and his government were up to. More than the committee ever dreamed he would be.
It's amazing what a little hard evidence will do.
Yeah, isn't it? Klaus also admitted responsibility for 3 other similar secret operations.
The Yard asked me to thank you for sharing our report. With it, they've been able to link Moya to the murder of 3 undercover agents.
And Harry. In a way, Moya killed her too.
I'd like to think Moya regretted that death. But I doubted she'd already been turned into a machine.
It's the ethics and the motives of the creators that have to be blamed.
Yes, we're forgetting that though the results of Arno's experiments were truly tragic, the possibilities extraordinary.
We watched eagerly when they let the genie out of his bottle. But now we have to learn to keep him our servant, not our master.